An exciting time here at the RBC Heritage. Many of the biggest names in golf competing for the iconic plaid jacket, and all 69 golfers have an opportunity to do so. Remember, since this is one of the PGA Tour's signature events, there is no cut. Four different golfers entering Saturday with a share of the lead, and the number of fans increasing as we enter the weekend, not wanting to miss any of the action. Tom Hoagie, Sepp Straka, Colin Morikawa, and JT Poston tied for first place at 11 under. The leaders teeing off later in the day. 2024 Masters champion Scottie Scheffler begins the third round, two strokes back of the lead, but he would prove just why he's one of the best golfers in the world. After four birdies through his first seven holes, Scheffler seeks the short putt to save par on the eighth hole. Everywhere he went, the crowds followed, and understandably so. To the 19th, good first shot. He would be unable to get the eagle, but check this out. From 34 feet, Scotty Magic sinks the birdie putt and soars to the top of the leaderboard. Scheffler fires a 63 Saturday to take the solo lead at 16 under par. Sahith Tagala looking to bounce back on the ninth hole after a bogey on 8. A near eagle, but taps in for birdie. Tagala 2 under through 9 holes Saturday. Patrick Cantlay and Mackenzie Hughes paired together in the third round. Cantlay closes out a steady front 9 to stay even through 9 holes. Hughes tied for 5th entering Saturday. Great shot from the bunker, and he sinks for par on the 9th hole, but would have a nightmare back 9 with 4 bogeys to finish for the day. The Swedish superstar Ludvig Åberg, picking up where he left off, comes up just shy of the hole and settles for par. Åberg 3 under through 9 holes. To Colin Morikawa, who continues to bring the heat. Great approach shot from the fairway sets up for the birdie putt. Morikawa bogey-free through 9 holes to remain near the top of the leaderboard. JT Poston bouncing back in a big way after a double bogey on the 4th hole. He comes up short of the birdie, but manages to tap in for par. Tom Hoagie has played strong all week, and it was no different Saturday. Birdies on 3 of his last 4 holes, including this putt on 9. Savannah native Brian Harman having his share of struggles early. 3 bogeys on the front 9. However, he would bounce back. 15th hole sinks the short putt for birdie, one of 3 birdies on the back 9. Harman finishes at 4 under, tied for 45th. Take a look at the third round leaderboard. Scheffler holds the solo lead at 16 under par after firing a 63 in the third round. Sepp Straka one stroke behind, followed by Colin Morikawa. How about a 3-way tie for 4th at 13 under?
Felt like my ball striking was really good today. Hit a lot of greens. I played the par 5 as well. The par 3s I felt like today were playing very challenging, and I did. And I played the par 3s really well. So overall, it was a good effort. I'm proud of the score today.
It was not as good a ball striking round as the first 2 days. I knew it probably wasn't going to continue the way it did, but yeah, just hung in there, grinded it out, and really started hitting the ball nicely on the back 9. It's always hard to kind of start off a little shaky and then recover and hit some good shots coming in. And yeah, I did that pretty nicely.
Okay, I absolutely want to win. There's no reason why. You know, you look at the past 2 weeks, it's like, okay, I've given myself chances. It's time to close one out. And I think for tomorrow, I just got to, you know, stay within myself and play my game. I really got to stick to my game plan, stick to how I have plotted out this golf course, and go from there.